Stephen T. Williams here, and I'm standing in this gorgeous park on this beautiful morning. Cars to my left, a park to my right, and me in the center. So here I am, and I'm about to do a monologue for you. So here it goes, The Taking of Miss Janie by Ed Bullins, and I shall be playing the character of Len. By my appearance, you wouldn't expect me to be a great teacher, would you? But I am a great teacher. An influencer of men and, a lover of the finer things in life, such as art, literature, theater, fast cars, good food, and women, especially. In fact, I nourished some of these tastes in my friend Monty, and a few of them have been taken and cultivated by him, especially the finer ones, like drama. Yes, yes indeed. And it was I who first taught Rick about nationalism, black nationalism. He read Garvey in the books I loaned him, and encountered the Righteous Brothers of the Nation of Islam at my Sunday black cultural discussions and teas. And it was I who first explained to him who was the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, and cite the messenger's importance to contemporary black America. Now one might ask, what's so great about pulling his coat to things he'll find out sooner or later? But you're now seeing Rick at his neophyte state. As soon as this decade is out, the 60s, he becomes a large national figure on the black revolutionary scene. Falls after his rise like so many of his brothers in the struggle. But it was nationalism that lit the fires in his ambitious heart. So don't put down nationalism. It is the stuff that fuels revolutions. Agreed? Now, one can even say that the Zionists are the nationalists of Israel, couldn't one? And that Al-Fatah and other Arab terrorist organizations, good morning, are the nationalists of occupied Palestine. Nationalism translated means national liberation, wherever that nation stands. But these are arguments that will take too long to deal with. Tonight we're looking into, or this morning, we're looking into some of the makings of the 60s, which of course went to make the 70s. Just think, at this moment in our story, many things have yet to occur. Malcolm X hasn't passed from the scene. The Kennedys have still to be disposed of. Watts has to happen. Martin Luther King Jr. must go to the mountain, never to return. Many things are spoken of here. And the writer of this integrated social epic hints at only some surface manifestations of the time. For he did not know the impact of these accidental associations. He did not know that through me, he would discover the kernel of political truth of the era, the seminal social sweep of the vision of so much history. But I'm getting long-winded. There's so much to say in so little time, but just remember that more cultural and psychological phenomena came out of Southern California within the mid-century than Richard Nixon and Walt Disney. Thank you. Mama told me.
I can hear the God of history saying, that was not enough. But I was hungry, and ye fed me not.